days we are surrounded by video. Everyone captures moments by phone, camera, or drone. Some do this professionally, others have dashboard camera recorders in their cars. And so often, we capture unique moments, something that will never happen again, captured in the nick of time. A wedding, live music, a child's first step. But these moments can be corrupted or lost due to problems specific to modern cameras. While recording, a camera writes video data through to storage, but keeps indices and metadata in memory, discarding that at the end of a recorded file. If corruption happens, all the collected indices and metadata are lost. The entire video file is invalid and cannot be played back by normal methods. The good news is many of these are recoverable problems and we can help. To restore your video, we need two similar video files from your camera, the corrupted video and, as a reference, a good video which has been recorded with the same settings and from that same camera. Both of these could be on one SD card or two separate cards, and we can use this reference file to find and repair the missing data. When your video is crucial or has precious footage, and you are uncertain if the data has been corrupted, the first thing you should do is remove the flashcard from the camera. If it is an SD card, lock it to make sure whatever is there cannot be lost or overwritten. You could put a micro SD card in an SD adapter and lock that as well. To restore your media, you first specify a camera make and the model, and then upload the reference file. Once this is done and the reference file is validated, you then upload the broken video file. It is very important that the reference file is recorded with the same settings that you used for the broken one. For example, if a broken video was recorded at 1080p, a reference file recorded at 720p won't do. Files can be large, so uploading and processing can take time. Once both files are uploaded, you can close your browser. We will notify you by email when processing is complete. For every restored file, we will share a few screenshots and a short preview video. You can review the screenshots and preview video and decide if you are satisfied with the result or would like us to try again using a different reference file or different parameters. If you're satisfied, you can download and enjoy your restored video. Here is an example of where ejecting and locking that SD card after that important event could have made corrupted data salvageable. This dashboard camera recorder has recorded a traffic accident. If you inspect the SD card content, you will see the list of recorded files. These last three are the ones that interest us. The second file contains the video of the event, but it is broken and does not play back. The third file has been recorded after the event, after the camera was turned on again. Restore.Media might be able to restore the second file using the first file as a reference. This first file size would be correct, even though the second file's viewable video stops at about a minute before the event because of missing file system metadata. The video data has been written, but because file system changes are missing, the system effectively makes that area free and available for writing new files. But because the camera was turned on again, it's possibly too late to salvage the corrupted video in this particular case, because the third file may have been written over that last minute of the video. This is why we strongly suggest removing the media card as soon as possible before the camera is turned on again and immediately locking the card from being written to. When it comes to choosing the best method towards restoration, we have several options. The easiest one relies on our restoration algorithms, which are continually updated and can automatically detect the optimal method of restoration. If you prefer a more manual approach, you can either select the method you believe would work better to replace the broken file, or you can have one of our engineers personally review and manually restore your file. The next step would be to make an exact binary image of the flashcard, byte by byte. For a 32 gigabyte card, the image file would be exactly 32 gigabytes. You can use one of the free image creation tools that we've linked below. With your image file in hand, please contact us for your manual restoration. Back to the example given earlier of the video file taken during the car accident, the owner of the camera got very lucky. That AMBA1377.MOV file was written to a free area, not over the corrupted data, leaving the missing 1 minute video chunk untouched. And Restore.Media was able to restore it manually for them. Please feel free to contact us if you are in a similar situation and need to restore your video. We are here to help. Be safe and happy recording.